Hey guys, this is Overlord Actual. Today we're going to be taking a look at the new Microsoft Store for the Xbox. Alright, so when you first launch the store, at least when I first launched the store, it takes me to the this new Deals tab. Let's click through to this Metro Publisher sale. So, as you can see, the app itself looks pretty similar to the Game Pass app on the PC, or at least aesthetically. It looks really, really similar now. I like how, like, all of the games are, like, displayed here as opposed to the old one. This just looks a lot better. I don't know if they exactly fit more on the page, but it just looks better this way than before. If you go take a look at your store on the Xbox, you'll know what I mean. Hopefully you'll agree that this looks a lot better. If you notice in the top right hand corner, it keeps playing like the trailer for the game. Hopefully they changed it to where that doesn't play as soon as like you move to a new thing or like the different tab or a game, because I find it pretty annoying just having the trailer automatically play for a game you're hovering over. But, you know, it's not that big of a deal. I like that it's there, it's just maybe give it a couple seconds. Let's see. Yeah. I think this looks a lot better. So this is like a Bethesda publisher sale thing. All those look better. You can see also there's like tags for the game up there in the top left hand corner. That's like straight from the Game Pass app on the PC. Or the Xbox app too, which I like it. It's kind of cool. It's not really super helpful to me because I can tell what kind of game it is, but maybe if you're like in the search thing and you just search for that type of game, it can be kind of helpful. So this is the new home screen. You got some more of the advertisements up here for like, this is what, Black Desert. This thing up here is a Netflix like crossover thing, I'm pretty sure. At least on the homepage, that's what it was showing before. Then you scroll down and you kind of got the same order of things that you already have, like games, goes to Game Pass, movies, TV stuff, apps, and then the hardware. They kind of click through on that. This is a controller I use. Unfortunately, these things have like terrible durability or something. They just keep wearing, they wear down pretty quick. Yeah, me and my brother have had to get so many of these replaced, so kind of frustrating. But you keep getting it because, I mean, it's truly like the best controller you'll ever hold in your hands, in my opinion. It's really good, but not the point. Everything is saying like unavailable. Like you can't purchase any of these in terms of like hardware, even like the Xbox consoles. So I think that might just be something up with the store currently. I'm not gonna look too much into that, but yeah, that's kind of the new home stuff. Yeah, click through to top free games. So I like the way this menu looks. Maybe they need to make it so there's like two rows of games, but that might clutter the screen too much for some people. This one row is fine because you can kind of see a preview of the upcoming row, so it's not too bad. Let's see, filter, yeah, the genres. Well, they can make this menu drop down way more than that. That is kind of ridiculous to only have three things there. Number of players. That's not what I think of when I think number of players. I kind of think how they had it on the back of like game cases, and maybe they still do, but it was just like online or local 1-4, online like 2-16, like the Halo, like the old Halo games on 360. And capability. Yeah, this menu's gotta add, like, they gotta drop this down to where it can have way more stuff shown, but that's okay. They can do, like, HDR, Xbox One Enhanced, 4K. Oh wow, you can sort by rating now. That's kind of cool. Oh, okay. I'm trying to get to the sort by thing. It's not. Maybe I have. Oh, let's see. Hold on. Yeah, it's not letting me get to that sort by. That's whatever. Alright, let's see. Quick actions. Add the wish list. Okay, that's kind of cool. I know it's free to play, but let's just add it to wish list just for later. Alright. Game Pass stuff. Let me flip through this. Okay, yeah. It shows the discount, like, with Game Pass. It's got their little Game Pass logo. That's kind of cool. I wonder if this is updated like on a monthly basis or like the new games for the month or something like that. Because there's not really a lot in here. That's kind of cool. Apps. The rest of that stuff I don't particularly care about too much, so let's go to games. You got your normal top free, top paid, Game Pass, and a search thing, so that's pretty familiar. Let's see, what is this? Compare editions. Oh, there we go. Okay, that's kind of whatever. They've got a based on recent activity, which all of this makes sense to me. I do a lot of Halo stuff, so. New games, and then you can see all of the tags down there for it. So that's pretty cool. Might be helpful for some people. Xbox One Enhanced. I assume eventually that's going to change to like Series X Enhanced. Or they might keep both of them. You never know. Got a bundle tag. Not sure about that. Oh, well, yeah. It's free, so. Let's go to a paid game real quick and something, yeah, with a bunch of different editions because I want to show you that now it just pulls it up like this. So before you'd have to like click through the other edition and it would pull up that one store page. And then you can see what everything, like what all is included in the game. I like this better. You can just kind of scroll through all of the DLC stuff. A lot quicker, a lot simpler. We'll add this to wishlist. I don't really want this game, but anyway. I do like this tab here. Just makes it so you can kind of get through to certain things a lot quicker. As like before, you'd have to click you'd have to go through quite a few different menus just to get where you wanted to get to. One thing I wish they'd add here is the game demos. Does that exist if you scroll down far enough? But for whatever reason, they don't seem to want to advertise game demos too much. Obviously, game demos haven't been a big part of this generation, which is really sad in my opinion. But you know, it's whatever. They still exist. I know where to find them. It's just I wish they'd pit them more into people's faces. I think that would help out. Then yeah, you got game preview. So all of these menus are mostly the same. I think this Xbox Play Anywhere might be new, but I could be mistaken on that one. Let's see. I'm gonna add this to wishlist too. I'll show you why later. The movies and TV apps. So you notice like up here at the home page it has like all of those things, but you know you can come over here and they've all got their own much bigger, like more flushed out menu to them, so that's really nice. Even the hardware stuff. So Xbox Series X. Sure, let's take a look at that. And do sign up for email. I'm pretty sure I'm already signed up, so that doesn't really matter. When I hit B on that, it takes me back to the home menu instead of back to just the store, which is, I think that's a little weird, but. So now you got the wishlist, and so I want to know how far down, like how many things can you add to this to where it'll just be like, okay, and then you view the rest of the games. Because it's, I mean, I guess the view list thing is right there, so I guess you can just let people scroll through this forever, but I think after a while, it's not gonna keep showing you all of this stuff. So anyway, let's go to view list. And this menu looks really nice. I think we all need to add Cyberpunk to their list. Everyone should be getting that game. Looks really good. You can make the wishlist private or public. I'll just make it public. I don't really see why you wouldn't. Then you can turn on notifications, and it'll let you know when they're available, and it'll let you know when you got the special deals for them. So what it'll probably do is show up as a notification from the Xbox, and instead of Xbox right there, it'll probably show Microsoft Store. A game on your wishlist is on sale, and it'll probably have a link right to the game. Then you got recently viewed stuff. Clear that list. Let's see, you got redeem. Just type in 25 character code like normal. Pulling the triggers doesn't seem to work on this menu here. I kind of wish it would push you all the way to the top or all the way to the bottom. But that's whatever. Settings, they're gonna have to work on this menu. Push this thing out a little bit. It's like right up on the edge. Not a big deal, because the only thing here is it just takes you to the Xbox settings, so doesn't seem really useful for this store, if I'm honest. But yeah, that's a kind of short preview of the store. I'm not sure when it's going to come to public release. It probably shouldn't be too long. Usually when they announce like updates that are coming soon like this, then these things just end up coming to the public pretty soon after. So might be like a couple of weeks or something like this. I imagine they'd want to get out to the general public. It's not like a full like dashboard overhaul. So I think the app looks really, really nice. It actually was pretty bug free this recording before I had like some issues. So, but looks pretty good, and I've already submitted some feedback for it. So hopefully you enjoyed the video, and thank you for watching.